Hello, I'm Aida, and I'll show you how to make a smooth skirt and animation in Alight Motion. We'll cover everything from designing a pleated skirt with both realistic and flat shading to animating it with flowing movement using some clever effects. Let's go! Chapter 1. Creating the skirt. Add a rectangle shape and make it tall. Then convert this rectangle to outline. Go to Edit Points and add a point at the middle of the ends. Bring the point lower and curve it. Now bring in your own pattern. I just stole a tileable pattern from Pinterest and I'll be making it repeat using the tiles effect. Bring the rectangle to the top. Select the rectangle and the pattern and pick Mask and Group. This will make the pattern appear only within the rectangle's area. Adding a waist squeeze. Add the pinch bulge effect from the distortion wire category. First, move the center to the top to simulate the waist, then increase the radius and adjust the strength to perfect the waist. Making the belt. Add a rectangle. Convert it to outline and curve the middle of it. I'll add a gradient and stroke to match the styling of a reference skirt. I'll also round the edges of the belt by adding the smoothen edges effect. Extra bits issue. You might see extra bits of the skirt above the belt. To fix this, add a circle, scale the circle in width, and bring the layer under the belt. And set the blending mode to exclude. This will exclude whatever is behind it, so make sure to group all the skirt layers before you put the skirt on a character. Chapter 2. Appearance of the skirt. Add the turbulence effect from the procedural category. Select the stretch property, tap on the Y and decrease the value. Adjust the value of the X property as well to get linear streaks like this. These streaks are mimicking pleats, which are the deliberate folds in the fabric. Once they appear, you can adjust the colors. Keep the colors black and white if you wish for the pattern under it to show up. Go to the end of the effect settings and set the blending mode to multiply. This will allow the pattern underneath to show up. If the shading is not to your liking, adjust the bias and intensity properties to adjust the shading of the skirt. Bring the turbulence effect under the pinch bulge effect. I'll move the top points just a little bit, which seems to make it look better. Realistic shaded skirt. If you want it to look even more realistic, you can add gradient overlays and apply a shadow over the skirt, then an ambient light on top of that shadow. However, if you want a skirt in that flat shading style, flat shaded skirt. For the flat skirt shading, get rid of any gradient overlays. You can also set the blending mode to normal to hide the pattern and get only the pleats. Now, you have two options. Either add the threshold effect from the color and light category, along with the gradient map effect for a monocolored skirt, or use the palette map effect with the custom color palettes. No shading at all. If you don't want these shaded pleats, you can hide the turbulence effect, but for now, don't. We need the turbulence effect for getting those ends of the skirt, which is the thing that seals the deal of the skirt actually looking like a skirt. Chapter 3. Animating the skirt. To animate this skirt here, I'll first add bookmarks where I'll put my keyframes in. This will help me navigate to the keyframes faster. The first bookmark is where the skirt turn animation will start, and the second bookmark is where we'll have the skirt turn end. Animating the pleats. Take a skirt and go to the turbulence effect, take the offset property, add a keyframe to start the animation, Go to the second bookmark and move the offset property. I'll move the offset property to the right since I want my skirt to turn right. I'll add an ease out effect to make the animation flow more smoothly. Animating the pattern. Take your skirt group and go inside the group through edit group. I'll put my bookmarks in here too, in the same frames as before. Then take the tiled pattern from move and transform, animate the location property. Make the skirt move in the same direction as you animated the pleats. Duplicating the skirt to pleat the ends. Very important. Now we'll take our skirt from this to this. Duplicate the skirt layer and hide the original skirt layer. Take the skirt copy layer and add the wipe effect for the matte mask key category. Set the angle to 90 degrees and increase the start property. Increase the feather property as well and make it look like this. Unhide our original skirt layer. Take the copy layer and set the blending mode of the turbulence effect to normal. Add the displacement map effect to the copy layer and adjust the Y offset to create this variation of ends. You can increase the stretch and scale of the turbulence effect to adjust the width of these pleated ends. Since we animated the offset earlier, these pleated ends will already be animated. Yay! You can now hide the turbulence effect from the original skirt layer if you want to. It's up to you. I'll hide the pattern for now since it's causing a blurry preview. Animating the skirt. Our fabric is already animated. Now we need to add movement to the skirt to show the skirt is actually moving. I'll show you two effects to animate the skirts with, one you're very familiar with, and the other one, a secret. Select all the skirt layers and put them in a group before we start. Effect 1. Bend effect. I'll add the bend effect and set the origin to top to animate the skirt by animating the angle property. When the character turns, the dress will follow with a little delay. I'll use the ease out graph for a smoother flow. Right here, a little turn of the fabric is necessary because the fabric should literally bounce back at the movement. So, I'll make the pleats overshoot just by a teeny tiny bit. Overshoot is when an animation moves a bit past where it's supposed to stop, then comes back and settles. If you're going to make changes to the original skirt layer's turbulence effect, make sure to bring those changes to the copy layer too. I'll lengthen the duration of the layers just a bit, and this is where I got confused for a moment, because where did the pleated ends go? To bring them back, just go inside the skirt group and change the group's background color to black. And if your skirt looks a bit wrong in the pleats, then fix the offset of the turbulence effect. Delay technique. Duplicate the bend effect, Delay the keyframes by a few frames, it makes the animation look so much smoother. Decrease the start property to make the bending start from near the ends of the skirt. This is called follow through, but I like calling it the delay. Effect 2. This secret effect is the pinch bulge effect from the distortion warp category. Add a pinch bulge effect with a higher radius and adjust the center to deform the skirt however you want to. You can and should animate the center property to warp the skirt. You can add as many pinch bulges as you want to get the skirt to behave however you want it to. Just experiment. Copy movements of a skirt footage. Just do it. I'm targeting the distortion around the sides of the skirt and at the knees and ends. Just know that this is a bit of a time-consuming process. See that beautiful extra movement? Exactly that. I can see the skirt looks a bit wonky. This is happening because I didn't add the overshoot animation onto the fabric. I'll fix it in under a minute. Placing the skirt on a character. Put the skirt above the body or torso layer and either group it or parent the skirt to the body. You can even add a parenting helper with a weighted rotation to make the skirt rotate automatically when the body is rotated. That's about it.